Yeah. Okay, deep breath.
Okay, yes. It's not actually a penis. It just looks like this. It looks like one. It looks like one. It looks like one. I don't know what kind of penises you're used to, but it looks like an
ant. I know you guys. Oh my god. Oh God, you guys.
That's like a shiwi.
Yeah, shiwi. Exactly. It's just basically a thing where you can pee standing up. And I know it sounds awful, but it's like, it beats, I mean, like, if you're camping or whatever, it beats squatting down in the weeds and having God knows what crawl up your hoo-ha. I mean, you can
No, probably not. Probably not. The menstrual cup, though. Hey.
Well, if you're like going in the dark or something, you don't know what's in those weeds. You know, there's a snake in the desert.
Okay. Oh, God. That's no fun. Come on.
Call me on the show.
Oh my God.
Oh, yeah, you'll be able to download the show.
Oh, my God.
We voted one of the best of the best of Michelle.
Yes, absolutely.
We voted Bob. Okay.
Okay.
Oh, my God.
Pressurized and you can't write your name in the
script. Well, that's no
yeah,
fun.
I don't know why we would think like, oh, great, I can do this.
And
I was like, no.
Yeah, okay, so what other uses could we use it for, though? You know, that was one thing as a prepper. They got to have multi-uses.
Well, for me, it speaks for itself.
Yep.
Kids are a real thing. There's things that are out there that it's just, you can actually literally just put it in their pee standing up. They even have disposable ones too, so you don't have to wash it. Okay. Anyway, for me, I think it's.
I'm sorry, I'm trying to be good.
Oh my God.
I don't own one. I've looked at them with horror, but.
Yeah. Yeah.
I used to, too, until I actually got one. And the first time I was out, like, hiking, and it's like, there's nowhere to go, and there's, like, all this dried brush around, and, you know, and it's like, it was just a horrifying thought to do that. That's all I kept thinking is, like, there's ticks. You know, you never know. So it's like, I actually did it, and I really did. I mean, it was easy. There was no problems with it. You know,
Go for it.
I was an outfitter, and I was taking a group of people on a horse trail ride through the mountains, and we were coming down this trail, and up above, I hear all these people laughing, and we're passing them, and I'm coming up, and there's this girl off to the side. She's peeing on the side of the trail, and she had to go, and she was so embarrassed, she pulled her shirt up over her head, so nobody would see her face, and she couldn't stop right in the middle. So I could see why that would be useful in this type of situation.
There you go,
you don't need to take it with you to the mall just to prove you can pee standing up, you know?
Yeah.
it's designed for camping and different things like that, hiking, so you don't have to do things like that, you know, if you don't want to. Alternative than having to do that, and especially, like I said, if you're out camping with you know, friends or whatever, you know, when your drunk friends come through the window, you don't want to be down your pants down to your ankles, and you don't know if you need to jet real quick. You don't want the beer comes out.
And your drunk friend comes out and see you doing that, they're going to wonder. Yeah, you know that, right?
You got yourself a girl, you can poke him in the eye and run.
I was going to say, if a bear comes at you with your pants around your ankles, the last thing you're going to worry about is whether you're...
Yeah. Very true.
You know what I mean? It's just a time issue. If your pants are down there, you know, you could run a lot faster. Get out of there quickly.
All right.
Don't get me started. I'm laughing any second.
I know. Well, this is just something that, like, you know, okay, we're going on to the next item. Okay, the next item is stuff for when a woman has her period. And there's things out there. I haven't tried any of these yet. I know people who have. There's something called the period panties. I don't know if you've heard of these.
Heard of
where
them?
They just basically absorb everything, and then you can wash them later. That there's no need for anything else, just those.
Yeah, and the menstrual cup,
No.
Yeah, doesn't that sound gross? I don't know. The menstrual cup, they have that out.
Yeah, I actually have a friend who used one. She swears by them. She says you can't feel nothing. That it's all absorbed with like this stuff. I don't even know what it is inside. But she says it works great.
Yeah.
So, I mean, it's just an option, you know, if that's what, you know, if you're in an apocalyptic situation or in a situation where you can't get to the store to just run and buy a pad or tampons or whatever real quick, that is something that you might have in your bug out bag just in case.
According to what I read, that menstrual cup lasts like 5 years. Thing.
They used to use that in the 1800s.
Yeah,
menstrual cups have been around for a very long time. That was
yes.
My next thing.
Yep.
They have been around for a very long time. Now, for me, I don't know if that's going to be something in an apocalyptic situation that you can actually have and keep clean, you know what I mean, the menstrual cup, unless you have, you know, an endless supply of water and things like that.
Well, you've got to wash out the other things, so... Either way.
Yeah, exactly. Now, so. There's this other product that I saw that I'm not sure about this one. It's called, it's like a sponge, like a sea sponge that people are using as tampons.
Uh-huh.
And they're reusable. Like, you take
it. Yeah, it seems like it would be a little more unsanitary.
Yeah, I mean, there's people, I mean, it's been all over, like, YouTube, all these things, because these are, like, the kind of products that I just like to look them up just to see, because as a woman, you need to know about these things.
Yeah.
Because you can't pack, you know, 5 months worth of tampons and pads and whatever else.
Not only that, but that gets expensive.
You're going to need something,
you
know.
Yeah, sure.
But there's women that swear by these things. They're supposedly naturally, They kill bacteria and things like that even after they're washed and stuff like that. I'm not sure that I would do that myself, but there's people out there that are doing it.
Yeah.
They're using these sponges to put up there. Maybe, I don't know if I want to get that close to SpongeBob and Under the Sea. But, you know. Pineapple. I'm sorry. Okay.
Yeah.
But yeah, I mean, these things that, you know, you're going to be inserting it inside you, so, and, you know, but like I said, they that are listening, I know this may be painful for you to hear, but it's like your wife, your daughter, sister, whoever, you know, you're going to need to know stuff like this. You know,
take like pads, too, washcloths or whatever you I mean, the Indians used to use cattail fluff. We've talked about that on other stuff. You take a bunch of fluff, stick it in between a couple layers, and it's like a pad. And then you can toss the cattail fluff and wash the pad and then use them over and over again.
Yeah, that's assuming you're going to have cattails and cattail fluff around you. That is a certain time of year.
Right.
Yeah, absolutely. There's several things that you can get and buy and, you know, Also, birth control. This is one thing I stress so much to our listeners. It's like, do not rely on somebody else. Do not say it's the men's job.